Hello, good evening. Welcome to the Music in Our Schools Month band concert. The concert band is going to kick off the evening with a piece called Ascending, which is kind of begins rather sadly with this recounting of, well, it's a story of a father and a son in Mount Everest. It's based on a true story. The father didn't make it climbing Mount Everest, and the son, 20 years later, climbs it. And it's a nice little story that I will not read you because it's really long what the composer writes, and I have something longer to read to you a little bit later. Anyhow, this is Ascending. Thanks again for being here. So this next piece, Hypnotic Fireflies by Brian Balmages, is going to feature some a couple unusual instruments and a lot of unusual sounds. Going to show you just a couple of the instruments so you know what to listen for. We'll use this as a sound check for the piano, okay? Can you just play the opening piano part, Andrew? So this is going to be kind of almost throughout the entire piece. It's part of the hypnotic part of the Fireflies. By the way, I don't think he's mentioned in the program, but Andrew Luswick is going to be playing piano in the back. If you can't see him, I know he's buried back there. Another instrument I'd like to point out is very unusual. It looks like maybe a science experiment gone horribly awry in the back, to the left of the gong, right behind Zoe. It is an amplified slinky. Yes, an amplified slinky. It's called for in the score. We have it mic'd up, and we're going to see if the mic and the slinky are working. Let's give it a go. So it's kind of this almost laser-like, Star Wars laser sound. And she can get different sounds depending on where she hits the slinky. The only other sound to mention is you'll hear some really low flute trills. They don't usually go that low. You'll hear some clarinet trills. You'll hear some trumpet trills that are really unusual and kind of mysterious. I'll let you figure out everything else you're going to hear. So the concept in this piece, in Hypnotic Fireflies, is that you are sitting in a field. I like to picture it on a hill. And it's a clear sky, but it's just dark enough that your eyes haven't adjusted, and it's really, there's no stars out quite yet. It's just a black sky, pretty much. Maybe a dark, oh, say, blue. So let's transition back to the meditation, hypnosis. So you are welcome to shut your eyes if you want and kind of imagine this, but you're going to hear like a single, hear musically and hopefully see in your mind a single firefly kind of in the distance. And then there's another one and another one and another one. And pretty soon the hypnotizing effect comes in and it just becomes this kind of magical sound, and we've turned it into also a light show, thanks to Mrs. Ordonez, who is our light board operator back there. So we hope you enjoy Hypnotic Fireflies. Thank you. Okay, so thank you very much. This will be the last song the concert band plays for today, and then we're going to transition quickly to wind ensemble. We kind of had an idea of having a movie theme. I mean, I did originally for this concert, and it just didn't quite evolve that way. Although you could see the first two songs being involved in a movie, and I think you'll imagine all three of the songs that wind ensemble are going to play could be movie songs for sure. However, this one actually is from the Disney movie, the first Disney movie, Beauty and the Beast, and since there's a new Beauty and the Beast coming out later this year, it seemed like an appropriate time to play it again. So this is Alan Menken's Beauty and the Beast.
Thank you.
So, trying to tie into the St. Patrick's Day theme, we're going to transition to Symphonic Winds, who has a whole bunch of it. Shannon Lake, I don't know where Shannon Lake is. I tried to find a Shannon Lake in Ohio, I couldn't. But the Shannon River is the biggest river in Ireland. So, we could rename this maybe Shannon River and make it an Irish theme. I don't know. I'm trying my best. The composer, Brant Carrick, who composed the first two songs that we're going to do here. Imagine this as being a summertime playing in the lake and having like a good old time at camp, basically, according to the notes in the score. So I think today and this week it would be really nice to think about swimming in a lake during the summer. This is Shannon Lake.
Thank you.
This next song, also the Brant Carrick song, Old Red Mill, reminds me of a lot of, the music reminds me of music from movies in the 90s like Dave. You know that like, just kind of like folksy American sweet melody that's played? And that same melody was used, I should have looked up who wrote it and what else it was used in, but it was used in a lot of movies. I wonder if you hear the same thing. Tell me after the concert. So I think that this wind ensemble, it's a small group. I think I said that back in December. There's a lot of people playing one on a part. And this is one of the strongest wind ensembles and the only group that I have tried to do Old Red Mill with. We've had this for several years. Mr. E picked it up many years ago. And I've never had any group take to it. And from the very beginning, this group just like got it and got the rhythms and got the intonation. They play it with great style. So we hope you enjoy this. Thank you.
stage.
I posted on... I didn't know I did that. Is Will Squires in here?
Yeah.
Ah, excellent, okay. I'm sorry, I said Will. Is Tom Squires in here? No? Did your brother not come? Did he have a rehearsal tonight? Your brother got me the mask. I posted on Facebook and 43 people said they had masks and like 900 said they had lightsabers, and I failed to get the lightsaber. Bummer. But I did get this. And I decided we probably shouldn't try to conduct with me wearing it. Okay, we need to put that somewhere else. Okay, I didn't know it made sounds. Unfortunately, it's not fair for this next piece for me just to put on a Darth Vader mask. There's also a Superman theme in here. And my mother brought me a cape. But I don't know how to get it on. Yeah. I was going to put it on and come out, and when she brought it to me an hour ago, I thought, no, this is not going to work. So you're going to hear a Star Wars theme at the end. You're going to hear Superman love theme from one of the original movies in the middle. And at the beginning is Live Long and Prosper, the original Star Trek series. So... Oh, some Trekkies out there. Nice, thank you. I left my communicator at home, though. This is a really cool arrangement that I've seen in our library for years, and I've never been able to justify doing it because not all three of these movies are contemporary, but now with the reboot of the original Star Trek series using the original music and all the Star Wars movies, and Superman is not... How long ago did we have a Superman movie? Two years ago. So they're all contemporary again, and it's a really cool arrangement, and this band is playing the snot out of it. I hope you enjoy Where No Man Has Gone Before.
John Philip Sousa wrote for a gentleman named Fauché, who was a businessman in Minneapolis. He built this tower, this big building, stuck his name on the front of it, and asked Mr. Sousa to write a march for him, which Mr. Sousa did. It's one of my favorite marches, but it was lost not too long after the march was first premiered in Minneapolis by Sousa's band, because the Great Depression hit and Mr. Fauché was found to be a financier of a house of cards. And Mr. Sousa was incredibly embarrassed that his name would be in any way, shape, or form associated with a building that said Fauché across the top. It wasn't until about 20 years ago that a musicologist, Daniel Dorf, was doing some work in the Library of Congress, going through some of Sousa's music, and lo and behold, up pops this manuscript of this march that musicologists knew was around, but no one had ever seen the parts. And I am thrilled that we can present it here tonight and start off our portion of the program, the month of March, Music in Our Schools Month, with the Fauché Tower March.
Thank you.
number one in music education class that they talk about with giving a concert, double check how the microphone turns on. Some of us don't ever learn even after 40 years. It is a distinct pleasure to present this next piece for you, this Loch Lomond. It is a beautiful setting of actually two songs from the British Isles. One, the Loch Lomond, a Scottish folk song that in the chorus you hear the words, "You take the high road and I'll take the low road and I'll get there before you." The Loch Lomond is a folk song from the time back in English history when the Scots wanted their own country. And 7,000 Scottish soldiers lost their lives in a battle against England, the great power, of course, in Europe. And the song is about two soldiers from the Scottish army who are prisoners. And one is going to be executed at dawn, and the other one is going to be allowed to live. And this folk song has to do with whichever one of them happens to die, they will take the low road. But their spirit will meet the person who takes the high road someday in the hereafter. This setting by Frank Tekeli is just beautiful. Frank Tekeli is a composition faculty member now at the University of Southern California, but when I got to know him, he was at the University of Michigan. And within this setting is also Danny Boy, the Irish folk song about the father who laments that his son is going off to war. And I thought it ironic as we were programming this concert tonight that Mr. Orlich started with the concert band with a piece that had to do with a father and a son. Those of you that have been to our concerts before know that when we have band material that is a treatment of another source, I like you to know what the original source was. So as a member of our faculty, Matt Schlesinger, our choral director, has graciously consented to sing for you the two folk songs that Mr. Kelly has then set in Loch Lomond. And it is really a blessing here at Hoffman the way our music faculty just happens to gel right, because Mr. Schlesinger was one of two students in the Lake Park High School band that did not march. The Lake Park High School band was a competitive marching band, and he was one of two students that didn't march. He is a vocal major by trade. Obviously, he is our choral director, a fabulous musician, and we are blessed to have him join us tonight. Please help me welcome Mr. Schlesinger to sing. What we would ask you as an audience to do, so that you are part of the performance as well, is that we will not applaud Mr. Schlesinger's beautiful renditions until after the band plays this setting, and then we will take time to appropriately acknowledge Mr. Schlesinger.
By yon bonny banks and by yon bonny braes, where the sun shines bright on Loch Lomond, where me and my true love were ever wont to gae, on the bonny, bonny banks o' Loch Lomond. Oh, ye'll take the high road, and I'll take the low road, and I'll be in Scotland afore ye. But me and my true love we'll ne'er meet again on the bonny, bonny banks o' Loch Lomond. Oh, Danny boy, the pipes are calling from glen to glen and down the mountainside. summer's gone and all the roses fallen. It's you must go and I must buy. But come ye back when summer's in the meadow, or when the valley's hushed and white with snow, and I'll be here in sunshine or in shadow. Oh, Danny.
Thank you.
We're going to close our portion of this concert and the concert with this medley of songs from Ireland. I won't remember all of the titles, but included in this is the folk song Minstrel Boy, Kathleen O'More, Cockles and Muscles. These little items that, you know, are very generic and indigenous to the Irish culture. Claire Grundman was, back in the early 40s and 50s, the writer for school band music, the way we use a lot of music by Robert Sheldon and James Swearingen and Brant Carrick and people like that today. Claire Grundman was that type of writer back then, and this is his setting of these Irish folk songs called Irish Rhapsody.